Oh, Lord, Lord, Lord. Many things happen.
And he says, who do you want? Jesus or Christ? And they said to him, let's hear it for Jesus. Jesus. Give us Jesus. Let's hear it for Christ. Give us blood! Give us blood! Wow. Okay, that's that problem out here. So the rabbit goes free, and Jesus is left there. Amen. Because the decision was made by the crowd. You better watch a lot of the crowd to make decisions for you. God said, so you somehow put it, well, everybody's doing it. You're right. And almost everybody got it.
Verses 27 through 32. Then the soldiers of the governors of Jesus into the common hall and gathered unto him a whole band of soldiers. And they stripped him and put him a scarlet robe. And when they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head, and a reed in his right hand. And he bowed the knee before him and mocked him, saying, Hail, King of the Jews.
Okay, let's start right there. Here, in and after they received the released Barabbas and took Jesus, the crowd gathered together, amen, and they began to take Jesus, and they took him and they planted a crown of thorns. What does that mean? That means that if you're familiar with a rose bush, on every rose bush there are thorns on a rose bush. Most of them, they range anywhere between 32nd of an inch to about a quarter of an inch. Some even a half of an inch. And that's very, very large for a rose bush. But on these thorns in that day, the type of thorns you're talking about something that started at
I got money and one of my eggs.
I got two eggs for
Emily.
I got
money.
Five eggs,
yours. I already got them.
Sure, here, I got five.
Okay.
I got money.
Sure, get out of
here.
Then he put a jacket of the dead fed. They matched it on his head. And blood ran down. On him. As they watched the blood fall, they began to mock him. And the soldiers stood in front of him with the crown. And they said, All hail, King Jesus, making mockery and making fun of him. But nevertheless, Jesus didn't say a word because he knew what his purpose was. See, as long as you can keep in your mind what your purpose is, you can keep something going.
Ghana. That is to say, west of the skull.
Okay, now, this place is called Ghana, or this place of the skull, it's one in the same. This is the place where they're going to hang Jesus upon the cross. This is the place where, amen, they take him and they nail his hands and they nail his feet. This is the place where they take the cross and they plant it in the ground.
Hey.
I'm here.
Smile. Cool. All right. Smile. Baby. Cohen. 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 Cohen.
Wish I'd have got to kick you.
Cohen. Cohen. Cohen.
They tell us, amen, that the historians even declared that he was a holy man and that he was a man of purity, and he was concerned about public worship. His family knew him as a man of integrity, and he was known as a man to never forsake, amen, Sabbath day worship.